Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This is another homebrew project. And the only thing I know about the designer is his name is Jesper. Maybe we'll find some more information when we go inside. This is of course the frequency. We got all the ranges. As far as I can see, it is a 10-3-10-3 kind of system. And if we look at the dial, it's also a 10-3 kind of system here on the dial. However, the dial is kind of loose. So that means I don't expect any kind of accuracy. I don't understand this. So this is the attenuator. But what is this? Yeah, that has something to do with turntable amplifiers and stuff. So why is this a thing here? Of course, a power and an indicator. And this is obviously the output power, output voltage. We got three different wave types. And what I see here is sweep. So you can crank the frequency range down to sweep, and then most likely you can do frequency modulation and AM amplitude modulation. So I would expect this will be input and this will be output, right? But that is all I know so far, except there is a note written here. And it says something about a big work to do with adjustment, homework, homemade, made, right? And it's based on the XR2206 and two times some, oh, well, that will be some op amps, right? And another op amp. Well, it's not defect, and there's no schematic. But the wire was cut. So this tells me I need to open it before I power it up. So I was in the middle of mounting a new connector, but I think we should take the lid off before I power it up. Let's look inside this fantastic function generator made by Jesper. So this is the PCB, and it is based on the fantastic XR2206. This is a famous function generator IC, and it will do a sine wave and triangle and all sorts of stuff. From 0.01 hertz to 1 megahertz, and its distortion is less than 1%, and its triangle linearity is less than 1%, and all that. It's really, really good, and I think it's been around since the 70s. They made many, many different versions, and they improved the quality and all that kind of stuff. But unfortunately, this one is a very, very early release of this chip. So I expect this one will have this spiky error. So I can't wait to see if that is the case. I think the op amps here, there are actually output filters and stuff like that, and they will maybe fix or cure the spiky error. So let's see if that is the case. Look, all those trimmers. That is also very, very impressive. I think this Jesper is maybe JG. So maybe his last name starts with a G? I don't know. No other information other than I actually wrote it here, because if I look under here, with some light and all that stuff, I can see written on the PCB in copper, there's a J78. So I think this design is from 78. That is a long time ago. And it looks like it is his own design. It's actually quite beautiful, this layout, if it's made on a film or something like that, right? See, it is definitely not a computer layout. It is a manual layout where you put these rubbing sheets on a piece of transparent plastic, and then you use UV light and film and all that stuff to make the PCB. There was definitely some sort of a layout error here. It's just fixed with those red wires, and I think this is on the this is on the secondary side. This is not the mains side. What do you think about the distance from mains to chassis? I think this is a little bit more than 1 millimeter. So this is not enough to pass the regulations we got today. And this is the chassis. Is also the ground output. There's a big fat wire for ground to the PCB. That is probably not the most beautiful kind of soldering. I've been looking a little bit on this layout and the whole detail, and I also the case and the front layout and the way that this is made with aluminium foil with text, and this is also a UV kind of film, this aluminium, and that was a very, very famous back in the 80s. I also made quite a lot of designs using this, and it really looks kind of professional. You can imagine this some 40 years ago, it would have been really, really nice. But I was thinking maybe this is from a work or an education project could have been. But yeah, let's try and power it up and see if it works. I put a new connector on it. Oh well, a new old connector on it. So let's see if it blows the fuses. So I think I'm ready to power it up. I think I set everything, so it should be more or less 1 kilohertz, full output, about here in the middle, sine wave. Maybe this is a lot if it's volts, all the way up to 10. I don't want that. Also, the distance between the bananas doesn't really follow any normal standards, so of course I can't plug any of my adapters into the holes. That's just how it is. So this is mains in, and I need my earth ground protection. Hang on a second. Okay, let's go. And it, of course, it works. Ooh, look at that connector. Oh my god, that is dodgy. How about this pot? It looks really... It looks like kind of digital, right? Hey, let's look at that. Yeah, this is the early model. Look at that. So this is the original chip from the 70s. That is definitely what we want. That is so funny. And also you see the top, it's like funny flat, and this one is a little bit more nice. This is a classic example of the first release of this chip. Isn't that fantastic? I got the old one. And like absolutely crappy contacts. But of course that is, oh my god, that is rubbish. Hang on a second, I need to clean this. I can't continue the video with this kind of absolutely. Okay, here we go. So let's see, that is the sine wave. Triangle, yes, exactly the same problem as, and here you can't see it, of course, because it's hidden in the transients. Well, I think actually you can see it. A little bit of overshoot and all that. But yeah, it's definitely working exactly as expected. So that is funny, but I really want to clean the contacts here, and let's play. Okay, the attenuator is just all or nothing, kind of. Yeah, okay, that is something I need to fix. That is just the worst contacts ever. Look at that. We made a random generator. Hopper, hopper. So I'm trying the sweep option and using the FM input. I am using an external ramp generator where I can put, where I can change the amplitude and the DC offset, and that will be the two things I'm playing with. So by dialing in the DC offset and the amplitude, I can of course select the lowest frequency and the highest frequency of the sweep, as you see here. So this is very useful if you want to use this for all sorts of funny sweeps. So I mean, it actually works. I'm a little bit curious about how this AM is implemented. So let's play with that. Let's get back to a fixed frequency and let's play a little bit with the AM input. Yes, of course, AM also works. Now look what I'm trying to do here. This is 1 kHz output and I'm modulating it with a 100 Hz, and I should try to dial in the frequency here. See if I could hit. Yeah, you see, you can do that. You can actually hit a frequency where it kind of collide. That looks really, really nice. So you can make some really cool waveforms by using the AM and the FM input here. I think it's a lot of fun. The more I play with this unit, the more stable, you see, it gets. It's actually getting really good now with the pot here. So all you have to do is use it, and then all the bad connections, they're gonna get lost. They're gonna go away. Yeah, yeah. See here, still have a little bit of funny stuff. And of course, the higher I go, the more you see the incoming modulation. And also you can see here, this is the input was clipping. So I go down, and this is of course, now it's, I am in sine wave. I can just go down a little bit and I can like adjust the DC offset as well. And this way I can obtain the exact waveform I want. And this is my signal. So you can really build a really nice function generator using the XR2206. If you find this video interesting and want to play a little bit more with this generator, please go and look this IC up. Just Google XR2206 function signal generator, and you will find a million sites where you can buy all sorts of little PCBs or ready-made or solder yourself kits and stuff for like $10, $20, $30, and they are really nice, and they are the new version that don't have this little spiky thing, and they also have a sine wave that looks a lot better than the one I just showed you.